talked about. And then it gets into more complex things in non-Euclidean geometry, but I'm going to stop it early.
Non-Euclidean Geometry by Rafi Cohen and Kavya Acharya. The story of non-Euclidean geometry begins with the proposal of Euclidean geometry. Euclid was a geometer from Alexandria during the 3rd century CE. To solidify the basis for his ideas, which would later become Euclidean geometry, he declared 5 basic postulates. He first drew 2 points. He declared that one and only one line segment exists that has the 2 points as endpoints. He then expanded on this idea and stated that through this line segment, one and only one line exists that contains the line segment. Next, he used the line segment as a radius and declared that each circle can only be formed by a unique line segment as a radius. Then he drew more lines, this time intersecting at right angles. He stated that all of the right angles formed must be congruent or share the same measure. His last postulate, however, was controversial because Euclid could not determine how to prove it. Euclid drew a line and a point not on this line. He stated that there was only one line that existed that was parallel to the given line and contained the point. This was known as the parallel postulate. Many geometers who followed him or who read his work would question it, and this questioning gave rise to new geometries.
Okay, so, like I said, the 4 mathematicians that actually, like, questioned it and found proofs and stuff were the 4 that I mentioned. I forgot to add a point on one of those. So add a point to the very top line, probably in the middle of the line. And I got a little more to show you on the video.
The question was raised, what would a geometry look like if the parallel postulate or even other postulates were false? But how would a geometry modeled after this look? In the 1830s, 2 bold geometers attempted to answer this question, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky and Janos Bolyai. In order to discover the new geometry, they needed a different perspective, a different basis. They both looked to the skies, a great circle which to them appeared to touch the horizon. In the sky, they both saw spherical masses, stars, planets, and moons. The Earth itself was a sphere. This, they determined, was to be their basis. We live on a sphere, and what we can observe in the universe beyond the Earth's atmosphere is also spherical.
In order to contemplate this, they imagined a globe, or Earth as their plane. A line, a continuous path of points which continues on forever, would therefore be the great circle on the globe. In other words, the intersection of the sphere and a plane passing through the origin, or an equator. With this basis, Lobachevsky and Bolyai, although working independently, both concluded that they needed to project the sphere onto a plane. Shown here in yellow is the equivalent...
Okay, they get into triangles, but do you have a pen?